Hello everyone, welcome back with another new video. And don't forget to subscribe the channel. This was taken on a weekday and the day we spent with few recipes will be coming up soon. Keep watching the video till the end without skipping. Since we are spending our day with work from home schedule nowadays, the days are really hectic without any special dishes. So thought of doing some special dishes at least for the dinner and the snack. Before that we had to buy some groceries and we had to leave Mishra with her grandparents. You all know why, because it's not safe to take her out for the grocery shoppings. So I quickly diverted her with her grandparents and we had to go out without her knowledge. Which is really difficult nowadays. The day was very sunny and I couldn't cover up the shopping areas because we were really in a hurry buddy to come back and had a lot of work. But we were hungry, so we dropped at Ram's Tea House. I wanted to tell about their tea. I actually tried their ingredients for my masala chai that I've already posted in my channel. You can check out the iCard. That is not the real ingredients maybe, because they will have their secret ingredients, but it was tasting like it. For at least 80 to 90%. Coming back home, finished some work and I had to quickly prepare a favorite dish of my husband. KFC style popcorn chicken. I've already posted a video on KFC style fried chicken. You can check it out in my iCard or description box. So for the marination, I'm taking 3/4 cup of curd, which is really thick. And also 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste and 1 teaspoon of chili powder. You can adjust the chili powder according to your need and salt according to your need, and minced coriander leaves. Mix it well and that is going to be the main marination for the chicken. I've also taken 250 grams of boneless chicken. I've cut them into bite-sized pieces. The marination is well prepared and that has to go into the chicken. Mix it well with the chicken and that has to get marinated for 4 hours if you want a good result. But I was in a hurry buddy, so I only kept it for around 30 minutes in refrigerator until I prepared the other stuffs for this chicken. So now for the dusting, I have taken 2 cups of sifted maida. Along with this, I will be adding the masalas. I have added 1 teaspoon of chili powder. If you want to reduce the amount of chili powder, you can reduce it. And also salt according to my need. And if you want to add more spices like cumin powder or oregano, it will also taste good but might change the KFC effect. Now I am also taking 2 eggs into the mixing bowl and whisking it well together. So now everything is ready. I'm taking the chicken out from the refrigerator that is coated well. So now let me dust the chicken first with the maida. I'm taking like 5 pieces at a time. Do not overcrowd it. The maida will become really wet and that will spoil it. So out from the maida and I'm gonna dip it in the egg. Now comes the second coating with maida. Here I have not added any kind of corn flour or corn flakes and breadcrumbs and all. It is going to be only maida. So the second coating, we have to press the chicken and coat it well and dust the excess. Heat the oil side by so that it gets hot, really hot, before you put the chicken inside. If the oil is not really hot or if the chicken is not dusted well, the flour will just get melted into the oil and it will spoil the oil and the chicken. While frying, you can keep the flame at medium to low so that the crispiness of the chicken is also achieved and the chicken will also cook well inside. When you get the perfect color at the perfect time, you have to remove it from the oil, otherwise it might get burnt. So that's the perfect golden color. Now let us look at the texture and how it has cooked inside. The texture is so crispy and nice. So inside the chicken is also cooked well. It tasted really well. Do try it at home and tell me. Meanwhile, my husband is having Oreo tub without giving me. That's our favorite flavor from Quality Walls. And do you want to look at Mishra's version? She's having it along with her cereals. Now, instead of tea or coffee, I'm preparing a milkshake, blackberry milkshake. The milk has to be really cold out from the refrigerator, and I have used Mala's blackberry jam for this. If you do not want to add jam into this, you can even add whole blackberries without seeds. So I'm also using the fresh malai from the milk, which is the main ingredient for this. So into the blender goes in milk along with malai, around 200 to 250 ml. Malai is nothing but palade in Tamil. Adding around 2 tablespoons of blackcurrant jam. Sorry, I stated blackberry in the beginning, but it is blackcurrant. As a sweetening agent, I'm adding 2 teaspoons of sugar. You can adjust it according to your need. This milkshake will be a little sour in taste. Blend it at high speed. Without any kind of thickening agent, without any ice cream, without any fresh cream, you're gonna get the thick milkshake out of this. Definitely make sure your milk is cold and you're adding malai into this. So now that is done. Can you see the texture? It is so thick. Now I'm going to slightly decorate the glass with a jam, just to give a look like a restaurant style. Now it's time to add the thick milkshake into it. Serve cold for your loved ones. Topping it up with more jam. When the jam is sticking onto the top part, you can see how thick the milkshake is. Everyone loved it. Now working on some plans along with my childhood favorite nice biscuit. I found it randomly in a market. Over to the dinner preparation, we made a masala pasta which actually tastes like a biryani masala. So this will be a pasta with a lot of Indian masalas and Indianized flavor. Heating up a pressure cooker. So this will be a dish which is cooked in pressure cooker. We also add minced meat in this, but right now I do not have it. So this will be like a empty biryani, like a kuska taste. Adding in 50 ml of coconut oil. Along with that, I'm adding whole spices like 2 cinnamon stick, 2 cardamoms and 1 cloves, because I do not like the flavor of cloves much. If you like the flavor of cloves, you can add more. Let it splutter for some time and it'll be a time to add 2 medium-sized onion which is chopped and fine. Adding in 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste. And when this is cooking, we should add a little amount of salt at this point in order to speed up the cooking time, and this will also prevent the ginger garlic paste getting stuck at the bottom of the pressure cooker. Once the onion is slightly become translucent, we shall add 1 split chili, green chili, and 1/2 teaspoon of red chili powder. You can adjust it according to your spice level. 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric powder and more salt at this point. Give it a stir and add a bunch of coriander leaves as much as you like and 2 medium sized tomatoes which is chopped in fine pieces. When the mixture is cooked well and has become slightly saucy, we shall add 4 cups of water. My cup measurement is 100 ml, that is 400 ml of water for 250 grams of pasta. Let that come to a boil. Now we shall soak 250 grams of pasta in some water until it just comes to a boil. Now the masala has come to a boil. It's time to add the soaked pasta into this. Give a good stir and mix it well. Now we shall wait again for that to get boiled. And now we shall close and cook for 1 whistle. So now after 1 whistle, this is how it looks. If you are adding too much water, it will become too soggy and the pasta will be like melted out. If you are adding too less water, it will just get stuck at the bottom of the pan. So make sure your measurements are good for this. Have it along with coconut chutney, it will taste like heaven. Do check out all the ingredients in my description box. I have given a detailed ingredients list for all my recipes. So that ends today's video. Do tell me how did the recipes turn out to be in your comment section, and also follow me on Facebook, Telegram, Pinterest and Instagram. All my links are there in the description box. Do like, share and subscribe the channel. Also suggest me for more recipes in the comment section. Until then, take care, bye bye.